We're going to do some leg lifts, a V-sit, and also toe touch punches. So I'm going to turn to the side when we do those, just to show you quickly. You come down onto the mat, or we're going to go up to the ceiling, and we're just crouching, trying to touch those toes. Okay. So let's go ahead and get started.
Yes, we do teach that with someone.
Yes, so the goal is to try to get the knees up off of the floor there. If you're
So as you can see here, Allison is starting the mermaid lying down. Ideally, she's already getting a stretch here on the top of her thigh, but ideally you want to try to take that toe all the way up to her head, which she's working on, but right now she's getting a deep enough stretch in her thigh that she doesn't need to go any further right now.
Okay, so next thing we're going to do here with Allison is a headstand. Okay, it's going up against the wall into our tuck position. This is your step number two. If you need to go over before this, go ahead over to lesson one. So, Ms. Allison, we're going to put our hands on the floor here. We're going to put the top of our head on the floor. Remember, we're making a triangle with our head. We're going to straighten our legs. We're going to walk our toes into the wall, into it, and we're going to hold it there. Okay, just to check. Get a little bit closer to the wall. Head closer to the wall. There we go. We're going to walk our toes in. Okay, so Allison, you walk those toes in as high as you can go. Both feet, walk those toes in. Toes. Yeah, she's going to bend one leg for me with a pointed foot. Now she's going to push off this bottom leg. Nice. To put her feet on the wall and hold that position. So you can see here she's a little bit too far away from the wall, so we're going to come down and try that again. Good. Let's put her head a little bit closer. Good, she's going to walk her toes in as close to her head as possible. She's going to bend one leg into half a tuck. She's going to push off this bottom leg. Get those feet on the wall. And she's going to hold it there. And she can also go ahead and straighten those legs. Oops. Okay, so we'll try again, and we're going to add those straight legs for you guys. Awesome, ready? Right. On the floor, put those toes in, and one foot. Give me a push off. And now she's going to straighten those legs. Pointed feet. Good. She's going to squeeze her butt. Hold, hold, hold. She's going to hold this by herself. Ready? Let's watch. There she goes. And she's going to come down one foot and one foot. Good job. We did it. So we're moving on to our elbow stands, doing all of our balancing and our stands here up against the wall first. We're going to place our elbows on the floor. Okay, we want to make sure that we don't have chicken wings. We want to keep those elbows in nice. Okay, we're going to tuck our toes under, stand up, see if you can walk those feet on the wall. You need to get a little closer. And we're going to hold it here. Make sure your head is off the floor. You can try and take one foot off the wall. There we go. And try and take the other foot off the wall. Point your toes. And coming down. Okay, so for our last balancing or stand up against the wall today, we're going to go onto handstands. So on our hands. First, I do the elbow test. I'm going to make sure that everybody has straight arms. They're not allowed to bend when I press them down. Oh, straight arms. There we go. Oh, keep them straight. Don't bend. Yes. Okay, so we're going to take those super long elbows. We're going to put them on the floor and walk our feet on the wall. Can we get closer? Get a lot closer. Together, we can lift one leg off, point your toes, straight knees, and slowly let go. And she's going to grab my hand. And grab my other hand. She's going to give you a big jump on three. 1, 2, 3. There we go. We're going to do our splits quickly to end the class. So we're up on our knees. Splits first. Up on our knees. We're going to place our right foot forward. We're going to put our hands on the floor. And slowly they're going to go as far as that they can go into that split. And if this is it, that's fine. Eventually she'll try to slide it all the way down and we'll hold the heel for a little bit. But I'm not going to take up too much time with the video again. Just make sure that you stretch again better yourself. So right split and same thing to the left split. And then let's go ahead and walk up into our straddles. With nice pointed toes, pressing the backs of the knees down into the floor, stretch over to the right leg, which would be my left, her right, and over to the other side. Just make sure that you're staying up straight, nice pointed toes, and then you stretch up into the right leg. Perfect. Walk it down the center, hold it there. And walk it back up, shake those legs back. So that was your pre-acro lesson 2. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys got some awesome exercises to either teach your students, to do at home with your parents, or with your friends. If you have any